Hi friends. Now let us take up the fifth and the last concept in the training session one. The five concepts are the most important concepts and core concepts. By understanding these five concepts, you can perform any program without any doubt, because whatever program we are going to perform from next training session may create several doubts because you are a new year. If we have this conceptual base of five concepts, you never get any doubt. Automatically, you can understand every statement, whatever you are writing, because such background we have given. That's why these are called basic. So, that is the importance of basic. Now, the fifth concept. The basic operations performed by a program. Already, I showed you a program, marks report program. It consists of 40 plus lines. Earlier, I showed you one classification. Actually, all statements in a program are divided into three groups: IPO, input, process and output. This is one type of division. Now, another type of division I show you, that is actually every statement regardless of the language in a program performs one job. Such activities are basic activities. Such activities are classified into five groups. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. First one, creating data, storing data, retrieving data, manipulating data, displaying result. Just simply remember, very easily remember. However, I can give you a very good example, by that you never forget. Creating data, storing data, retrieving data, manipulating data and displaying data. First, before giving a programming example, I give a general example. Creating data. Actually, this is an article. This should be stored in a container. What is the container? This is a container. I reserved this container for this. This is creating data. Means creating a variable. Creating data means what you have to understand? Creating a variable. Okay. Then container is ready. Next, storing data. What for this container? For storing data. You treat this one as a data. Okay. Storing data. Now, third one, retrieving data. Suppose simply I keep it here, there is no use. Retrieving data. I removed from the pocket. Manipulating data. I made some operations and I am displaying it to you. So, these are the five operations. This is general explanation, you never forget. Now, I give you programming example. Now, int age you have written. Int age, that means you want to create a variable. You want to create a variable. Its name is age. It's int. Okay, already I told you, it is a variable named memory container of a type. Create, this is what? This is creating data. Now, storing data. What I am doing? Int age 20. I initialized. Actually, this one don't treat it as mathematically equal to. Here, now how we are treating? You are treating it as a container. Okay, container I have given. Now, if you write this one and 20 or whatever value that is stored here. So, this is a container. This helps for storing whatever value you have given on right hand side into this container. This is called assignment operator. Call them as equal to, but it not equal to. You have to call it as assignment operator. Assignment operator pronunciation is very difficult. That's why simply call as equal to, but you should know that its purpose. So, what we did? Storing data. Two operations are done. Okay. Next year, what happened? Next month, September 15th, is your birthday. Then, what would be your age? 21. 21. Then what you have to do? The 20 you have to retrieve. Okay. Thereafter what you have to do? Manipulation. Manipulation means performing operation. That means whatever you made the operation. It may be plus, minus, division or anything. Then what happened? 21. This is manipulation of data. Retrieving data, manipulation of data. Okay. Then what happened? The 20 is replaced by 21. Because you manipulated and again stored. So, 21. Then, it is there in the memory. But how can you see that? So, then what do you do? You have to show it on the monitor screen. Then only, what is there in the computer memory, you can view. Simply storing computer memory, you cannot view. So, whenever it is displayed like this, then only you can know that. So, if any statement you take from a program that performs one of these operations. Also, once again I repeat that creating data means creating variable and storing data means storing variable like this. Thereafter, retrieving data means bring out the value. Manipulating data means performing any operation plus minus into division, any type of operation displaying data. Okay. Some of you get a doubt. Actually, in Python, we need not do this one and all that. Why you are doing? Actually, this is the original form. Your original form. So, whenever I am explaining, that I have to show to you. One example I tell you. Most mothers carry the bags of children up to school bus. Actually, carrying bag is the duty of the child. But mother is doing that. Because of that, you cannot say carrying bag is not there. Carrying bag is there. But child should do instead of for the sake of reducing the burden of the child, mother is taking care of. Mother is taking over the burden of the child. Understand? Python is doing that also only. Python is like your mother only. Being a programming student, you feel burdened. That's why what Python mother does, this you without doing anything, you need not write int. Python will do that internally. And you need not write this. Python will take care of. Whenever one line is complete, it puts this one internally. That point you have to understand. So, whenever you are learning a concept, you have to learn it in a basic model, not in the advanced model. That point always you remember. Okay. Here, actually, this is the way. Always remember creating data, storing data, retrieving data, manipulating data, and displaying data. So, with this basic knowledge, next training session onwards, you are going to perform programs. And from fourth training session onwards, fourth and fifth, you develop half a dozen projects. No doubt about that.